So I've heard a lot of misinformation about Stadia lately, and even if you knew everything the day of launch, so much has changed and improved that I'm going to give just a quick overview of what it takes to use Stadia. First, let us start with forget everything you've heard from YouTube content creators, even my little channel. Just forget all of that stuff. Up until a couple hours ago from when I was recording this, I am seeing popular gaming channels saying things about how Stadia works. That was never true, to the point where they were so far off that I wonder if they've ever actually used it. So if you are not a member and you buy a game from Stadia, it is yours to play without a membership. And if you're thinking to yourself, well, I don't have the Chromecast Ultra, I don't have the controller, you don't need them. They're great to have. I have them. I enjoy them, but you don't need them. That's not how I started playing even. Even though I'm a Founders Edition member, most of my gameplay has been without the official Stadia equipment. I started out with a wired 360 controller hooked to my PC and then started using Xbox One controller on my PC and on my phone. I still prefer the Xbox One controller above all, but when it comes to my phone, I've been using the Kishi Xbox controller, which I've actually had in other videos too. Here's a thumbnail of it. So don't forget everything. You can check out that video. That's a Kishi controller though. You might be thinking you want 4K and you're not going to pay $79.99 for the 4K Ultra and Stadia controller. That's great. Don't do it. Though it is true you can play only up to 1080 without a membership, with a membership you can play Stadia's higher resolution in Chrome if your Windows PC supports VP9. What the hell's VP9, you ask? I don't know. Who cares? Don't worry about it. If you're wondering what command line do you have to go through and dig to find out whether you have it or not, it's not that bad. Open up Chrome and just type in Chrome colon forward slash forward slash GPU and hit enter. What you're going to do is you're going to just basically look down as I have in the image on the screen and look for where it says if it's disabled or not. What if I don't have Chrome? Well, good news is you can do the same with the new Windows Edge that has Chromium slapped in it. But if you don't have Edge browser, install Chrome and good luck. I've been referring to a PC this whole time. I don't have a Mac myself, so I can't speak to how Chrome works with it on there. Linux, I haven't tried. This is strictly Windows PC. And the next part here about using an Android phone. You do also have the choice of using an Android phone, OS 6 or above, I believe. Even if you do not see your phone in the list, Stadia has put an experimental option in the menu that will let you try it out. As for iPhone, you can blame Apple for it not working at this time. That's something they got going on right now. Even xCloud's having an issue with that, or Gaming Pass, they call it now. Even though I'm not a personal fan of touchscreen controls, you can also play that way on your Android phone. It does come in handy if you have any of those games where you want to just do some quick stuff. I was playing some Dig World myself that way, and it worked out pretty good. If you have a membership and you're getting inferior performance, and it's not necessarily Stadia's fault. Just pump the brakes for a second. Let's check a couple things. First, can your browser handle the VP9? Check on that. You do need that for the higher resolution. Do you have 35 megabits per second faster connection? You can go to speedtest.net to get a rough idea on that. And I say rough because I don't trust any of those things 100%. But it is, a lot of people use it. Have you gone into the performance settings and verified you have up to the 4K checked? You can actually throttle your speed in there, and you want to make sure that you do have that checked. It would be nice if they had a per game setting, but right now that is kind of an all or none. Have you rebooted your PC? Have you rebooted your modem and your router? I work in an IT environment. I can't tell you how often that actually solves the problem. And I need to listen to that myself sometimes. I get very frustrated. And you know what? I just take the 30-second count. I don't even wait 30 seconds. I actually have it on a power strip. It's a battery-backed power strip that I just shut the battery off on, flick the power strip, count to 10, turn it all back on. Not a big deal. A big one, are you wired in? Yeah, I know. Everybody has the greatest Wi-Fi in their house. I even say the same thing. I got a mesh network. It's fantastic. I actually have Google's Wi-Fi mesh. I can prioritize my Stadia. At the end of the day, I got my 4K Ultra wired in, and most of my computers are wired in. But I have had good luck playing wirelessly on my laptop and not being wired in. But, you know, when it does have a problem, if I'm wireless, you know, it's a thing. Yeah, that is a lot of stuff to remember, but when you are asking for the best possible performance, you need to give it the best possible chance for success. Now, if you're concerned about data caps, this is something you really need to consider. You are using 100% internet to make this happen, and as you can see, it is a lot of data being transferred. Myself, for example, I have multiple gaming consoles. Stadia is just a convenience for me not to have to upgrade my PC. So even at 4K, I am in no danger of hitting my data cap. But this is something to keep in mind. And like in this image, the one that I was showing earlier, you can throttle it too. You don't have to use that much. And for anyone who's saying, well, I'm going to use Gaming Pass then because I want to have the higher resolution, and they're saying they're not using as much data. They're only 720p. So, and in fact, I'd like to get that out there now. I am a Game Pass Ultimate subscriber. I have both. I enjoy both. I believe in competition. It's a great thing. And it's kind of cool because I would say xCloud or Game Pass is like Netflix, where games are going to come and go. And I would say Stadia is more like Vudu, where once you have it, even though technically you don't actually ever really own any games, unless it's old cartridge stuff, some Switch stuff, as long as it doesn't need an update. The game library has grown. Yes, it was small when it was not that great 10 months ago. Today, I already have a backlog of games. I've not even played just from the free games I get every month from being a pro member. It was 6 games just this last month. I think it was 6 games a month before that. I mean, I can't keep up. Superhot, I did a video. I think I did a video on it. I should do a video on it if I haven't. That is a great game. I didn't think you could beat that game other than playing it in the PlayStation VR mode because that's fantastic. That's a great game even on hand control. Kind of off the subject, I'd like to see Stadia do VR. There's no reason with the VR things we can get in the stores for, you know, almost free. They're giving the stupid things away that they couldn't do something like that. As for the games I have bought, I can cancel my pro membership and play these at any time. Yeah, I lose the ability to play any of the games I received free as a member, but that's the same for PlayStation Plus and, you know, Game Pass and that stuff. But if I become a member again in the future, I have access to these games again. Once again, like the two other competitors, I wasn't saying that you don't get it with that. I'm just saying it works and functions like that. As for sales on games, you will see sales whether you're a pro member or not. You're just going to see more and bigger discounts as a pro member. We have not even mentioned free trials. As a member, Stadia will do free trials of games, and there's nothing bad about that. I do think Stadia should do something for non-pro members to give a taste of what it could be like. At the time of recording this video, Stadia has Pac-Man Mega Tunnel Battle, Immortals Phoenix Rising, and Humankind. I have not played any of these games, so I mean, I think that's great that they're on there. It gives me a chance to try those out. If you have made it this far, we really would appreciate a smash on that like button, and we'd love for you to subscribe. If you still think it's not worth it, that is cool. I mean, it's not for everyone, but I wanted to put some better information out there. I would love to have the following some of these bigger channels have. I personally think it's a huge discredit to you when they are not being honest. They are giving false information. I could keep talking about features of Stadia has, and even some they do not. I think I will leave it here for now, and I could keep talking about features Stadia has or even doesn't have. I mean, there's things that they haven't delivered on yet. There's small things. I mean, if you want to stream, there's still ways of streaming. There was supposed to be a better way of doing it, and I hope they do it because that's a whole other story. The resource intensity of it would be great from a streamer's perspective. But, I mean, otherwise, you know, is it perfect? Absolutely not. Neither is xCloud. NVIDIA Now, definitely not. So, I mean, there's things. It's improving. But, I mean, from where it was to where it is now, yeah, it was a terrible start. It's fantastic now. It's not hard. If you watched my first video months ago when I got the Founders Edition, my God, that is such a horrible video to watch. Well, one, I did a horrible job on it. And the other one, it's just, man, I don't know. But, I mean, I'm going to leave you with this. Once again, love it if you'd hit like on the video if you made it this far. But I'm gonna, like I said, I'm going to leave you with this. One of my biggest things that I am happy about Stadia for and I'm looking forward to is I've really been looking forward to Cyberpunk 2077. I hope it lives up to all the hype, but my PC can't handle it. I am not buying an Xbox Series system right now. I am not buying a PS5 system. I am not buying the game for my Xbox One S because I don't have the X. So, I mean, I'm still on the S. Stadia fills a gap for me. I'm not upgrading my PC to play that game. Maybe down the road someday, but not right now. My PC does everything except for massive gaming for me right now. And like I said, that's where Stadia fills the gap for me. So, I mean, other than that, I hope you got some use out of this video. I know some people, they're just going to be mad. They're always mad when I bring up stuff about this. But I'm not telling you need to get Stadia. I just wanted you to have some better information on it. So, other than that, thanks for watching.